हॅलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ मिस्टर जंगले संकेत सुरेंद्र, लेक्चरर फ्रॉम मुळा एज्युकेशन सोसायटीज, मुळा रुरल इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ फार्मसी, सोने. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द चॅप्टर मोनोफिजिक लिक्विड डोसेज फॉर्म्स. हिअर इट इज डिवायडेड इंटू व्हेरियस पार्ट्स. वी विल डिस्कस द पार्ट फर्स्ट. कंटेंट्स: दिस चॅप्टर कंटेंट्स द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ मोनोफिजिक लिक्विड डोसेज फॉर्म्स, classification, a detailed classification of monophysic liquid dosage forms, formulation studies of various dosages, storage and packaging, learning outcomes. At the end of this lecture, the learner will be able to understand the introduction, classification, formulation, storage and packaging of the monophysic liquid dosage forms. Now we will start with the introduction. Liquid dosage forms are commonly used in a pharmacy are either monophasic or biphasic. Monophasic liquid dosage forms, which refers to a liquid preparation in which there is only one phase. It is represented by a true solution. True solution means a solution which is a clear homogeneous mixture that is prepared by dissolving a solid, a liquid or a gas in a liquid. The component solution present in a large amount is known as solvent, and the component present in form. Monophasic liquid dosage forms are classified into two groups: liquid means for internal administration and liquid means for external application. Now here we will see the internal application. The examples are mixtures, syrup, elixir and linctuses. External applications, these are classified again into three types. First one is the application on the skin, whose examples are liniment and lotion. Second one is those monophasic liquid dosage forms which are used in a mouth, means by orally or by cleaning buccal cavity. They are gargles, mouthwash and throat paints. And those liquid dosage forms which are instilled into the body cavities, they are douche, ear drops, nasal drops and nasal sprays. Now further we will see the detail study of all this classification. Now we will start with the first one: liquids meant for internal administration. Liquid preparations for internal administration includes the various category of preparations such as mixtures, syrups, elixirs and linctuses. Now we will start with the detailed study of mixtures. Now what are the mixtures? A mixture is a liquid preparation meant for oral administration in which medicaments are dissolved, suspended in a suitable vehicle. Several doses are dispensed in a bottle. Are not prepared to keep them for a long period because they are mainly prescribed for acute conditions such as cough, indigestion, diarrhea, constipation, etc. So the mixture should be extemporaneously prepared and supplied only for small number of doses which can be used up within a short period. In case further need arises, then a fresh mixture should be prepared for the patients. Now, classification of mixtures. Mixtures are classified into five types. First one is the simple mixture containing soluble substances, mixture containing diffusible substances, mixture containing indiffusible substances, mixture containing precipitate forming liquids, mixture containing slightly soluble liquids. Now we will start with the first one: simple mixture containing soluble substances. Simple mixture contains only soluble ingredients. Examples are carminative mixtures, diarrhea mixture and expectorant mixture. Now the method of dispensing. It is classified or it is given in a 5 steps. First one, dissolve the solid substances in 3/4 volume of the vehicle. Examine the solution critically by holding it against the light. If foreign particles are visible, strain it through a cotton wool. Add any liquid ingredients. Add more of vehicle to produce the final volume. Transfer the mixture into bottle, cork it and then thoroughly pour. Simple mixture containing soluble substances is the potassium bromide mixture. Now the second one is the mixtures containing diffusible solids. Diffusible solids are those which do not dissolve in a water but may be mixed there with so that upon shaking the powder drug is evenly diffused throughout the liquid for sufficient time to ensure uniform distribution in dose. The commonly used diffusible drugs are bismuth carbonate, bismuth subnitrate, magnesium carbonate, it may be a heavy or light, magnesium oxide, it also may be a heavy or light, quinine sulfate and light kaolin, etc. Method of dispensing. Finally, powder the drug in a mortar. Add any soluble drug and mix. Measure 3/4 of the vehicle. Make a smooth cream by using the portion of the vehicle and then add the remaining portion of the measured vehicle. Transfer the content of mortar into a measure. Rinse the mortar with a little of vehicle and transfer it to a measure. Add any liquid ingredients. Add more of vehicle to produce the required volume. Transfer the mixture into the bottle, cork, label and dispense. Apply the secondary label, shake well the bottle before use. The example of mixture containing diffusible solid is the magnesium sulfate mixture. Now the third type of the mixture which are not soluble in water and do not remain uniformly distributed in the vehicle for sufficiently long time. Therefore, to suspend the drug, suspending agents are added. The commonly used indiffusible drugs in a mixture form are acetyl salicylic acid, quinine salicylate, calomel, phenacetin, benzoic acid, etc. Thus, suspending agents which are commonly used in the mixture containing indiffusible solids are compound tragacanth powder and tragacanth mucilage. Compound tragacanth powder is used in the proportion of 2 grams per 100 ml of the mixture and tragacanth mucilage is used in the preparation of 1/4 of the volume of the mixture. Compound tragacanth powder is used when the vehicle is other than water or chloroform water, but tragacanth mucilage is used when the vehicle is water or chloroform water. Now the method of dispensing by using compound tragacanth powder. Finally, powder indiffusible solids, add any soluble or diffusible solids and compound tragacanth powder and then mix. Measure 3/4 of the vehicle, make a smooth cream by using a portion of the vehicle and then add the remaining portion of the measured vehicle. Transfer the content of mortar into a measure, rinse the mortar with a little of vehicle and transfer it into a measure. Add any liquid ingredients, add more attach a label with a direction, shake the bottle well before use. Now the method of dispensing by using tragacanth mucilage. Finally, powder the indiffusible solids. Add any soluble or diffusible solids. Mix them uniformly. Triturate the material with tragacanth mucilage to form a smooth cream. Then gradually dilute with half of the vehicle. The product will thus measure 3/4 of the finished volume. Then step 3, 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th are same as described above in a compound tragacanth powder method. Now, mixtures containing precipitate forming liquids. Certain liquid preparations contain resinous matter. When mixed with water, the resin is precipitate, which may adhere to the sides of the bottle or form a clotted precipitate which will not rediffuse upon shaking. To prevent this, a compound tragacanth powder or tragacanth mucilage are used. Method of dispensing by using compound tragacanth powder. Finally, powder the indiffusible solid and diffusible solid in the mortar. Mix them with a compound powder of tragacanth in a mortar. Measure 3/4 of the vehicle and to this add a portion of it and triturate to form a smooth cream. Add the remaining part of the vehicle. Measure the precipitate forming liquid in a dry measure. Add it in a slow stream in the center of the cream with rapid stirring. Dissolve the soluble ingredients in a sufficient amount of vehicle. Add it slowly. Of the suspending agents. Step 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th are same as described in case of mixtures containing diffusible solids. Now, the method of dispensing using tragacanth mucilage. Tragacanth mucilage is used when the vehicle is water or chloroform water. Mix the tragacanth mucilage with an equal volume of the vehicle. Measure the precipitate forming liquid in a dry measure and pour slowly into the center of mucilage with constant stirring. Dissolve any solid substance in about 1/4 of the vehicle and mix it with the above mixture. Step 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th are same as described in a case of containing indiffusible solids. Now, the mixtures containing slightly soluble liquids. The insoluble portion of slightly soluble liquid is not readily diffusible. So, a suspending agent is needed to dispense such mixtures. Compound tragacanth powder and tragacanth mucilage are used in the same proportion as discussed in the mixture containing indiffusible solids. Now, starting with the formulation of mixture. The mixture consists of the two parts, vehicles and adjectants. Now we will start with the vehicles. The vehicle commonly used for the preparation of mixtures are water, aromatic water and medicated vehicles. Now we will see the first one, water. Purified water should be used for the preparation of mixtures. The mixture should never be prepared undesirable changes in the medicines dissolved in it. Sometimes freshly boiled and cooled purified water is used as a vehicle which is free from vegetative bacteria. Second one, aromatic water. These are saturated solution of volatile oil and volatile substance in purified water. Aromatic water is mainly used for its flavoring properties. Some of the aromatic waters are also having carminative and preservative action. So, aromatic water is used as a vehicle to improve palatability, flavor and preservation of mixtures. Examples: camphor water, chloroform water, peppermint water and cinnamon water. Medicated vehicles. Sometimes a vehicle with a definite therapeutic activity is prescribed. For example, compound genetian infusion, a bitter that stimulates appetite. Orange peel infusion, bitter and carminative. Orange infusion of Senega, expectorant, are used as a vehicle for preparing mixture. These infusions are prepared by diluting 1 volume of concentrated infusion with 7 volumes of a purified water. Now, we will start with the second point, that is adjectants. These are generally used to improve stability, color and flavor of the mixture. First one, a chemical stabilizer. Certain chemicals having antioxidants or reducing properties are used to improve the chemical stability of the derivatives are also used to prevent the darkness of mixtures due to the atmospheric oxidation. Coloring agents. No special coloring agents are added, but many mixture contains colored medicaments. Flavoring agents. The flavoring agents commonly used in a mixtures are aromatic water such as anise water, syrup and glycerol for sweetening children's preparation, liquid extract of licorice to mask the saline taste of certain mixture, spirit lemon to cover the taste of alkaline citrates, orange syrup and compound orange spirit to mask the metallic and astringent taste of iron salts in pediatric mixtures. Preservatives. Diluted vegetable extract and flavoring agents are the source of growth of bacteria and fungi in a mixture. Hence, chloroform and benzoic acid is used to preserve such mixtures. Storage of mixture. Mixtures are dispensed in plain glass bottles with uniform internal diameters. Bottles are available in 3 different sizes to supply mixtures of 60 ml, 120 ml and 240 ml. The mixture should be dispensed and supplied to the patient for not more than 3 days to prevent the deterioration. The bottle should be fitted with a suitable cork which will ensure it's easy removable and to prevent spilling of mixture. The mixture should be stored in a cool and dry place. Here we will stop in a part 1. Hope you understand